welcome to the world of my books and stories. In a previous video, I have talked about how you can create activities with a book for your child, you know, even before you have opened the book and started reading the story out. You know, you can check out the video. I will leave a link in the description box. Now, today's video is about the kinds of things that you can do as you're reading a book out with your child. Okay, so the first thing that you can do is when you read a book, you will come across words which are unfamiliar and new to your child. Always make it a point to explain what these words mean to your child, but rather than give them the meaning directly, allow your child to understand and to guess from the visual and the contextual clues what this word means. For example, you know, this is the book I'm using. This is written by me. Now here you have Chotu saying it was a flock of birds flying past. Now flock of birds, you know, flock is a word that is sure to be unfamiliar to your child. But rather than give the child the direct, you know, the meaning directly, let your child look at the picture. Is it just one bird? No, it isn't. There are lots of birds. So what are lots of birds called? And then from there, let your child understand that the word flock refers to several birds together. And then of course, you can always introduce other such collective nouns to your child. Okay, so rather than give the meaning directly, you know, when you do it in this way, what happens is that it helps your child look at the clues which are given in the book, both the visual clues and the clues of the context, and make a guess. And such words which have been learned in this way, you know, with the child's own participation, they stay on for much longer in the child's head than a word that you just directly and easily explain the meaning of. So do try this out and see how your child's vocabulary increases and improves. Now the next thing that you can do is to ask small questions. You know, don't make it an interrogation. This is not a test or an exam that your child is giving on the text, on this particular text, but just make it a fun kind of an question session. For example, in this very first page, you know, you don't have the child, you just have his foot there. So you can ask your child questions about who, why, what, where, when, how. You know, these are the simplest questions. So, you know, where do you think this is happening? You can ask, so your child can look at the clues given in this, in the illustration, and try and guess what do you think this person, this child is doing. Where do you think his parents are? You know, these are the kinds of questions you can ask your child and help them understand the book even more. For example, what do you think this boy is doing here? Why do you think he has to stand on this upturned tub? You know, and look at these, clothes hanging. So can you guess who they belong to? And then, you know, then you will know that who are the people in this child's family. Okay, so always ask little questions, not to intimidate your child or not to make your child feel as if he's being tested, but rather to help your child enjoy the story even more. Now the third thing that you can do is to ask your child to predict what is going to happen next. Now, for example, why do you think this boy looks so worried? What do you think he's going to do next? Okay? Or when the wind blows really hard, you know, what do you think the wind is doing? Because right here you have Chotu being blown off the terrace and holding on to the clothesline. So ask your child to predict what do you think happens next. You know, if this wind is really so strong, what will it do next? And then, you know, the joy of finding that their predictions are true is always going to make your child feel very, 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 you know, jubilant and triumphant. And even if the guesses aren't right, you know, it's still an opportunity to laugh. And the fourth and final thing that you can do as you read the book is to pause and look at the illustrations. You know, look at the kinds of details that you have in the illustrations and make sure that you draw your child's attention to these illustrations. Because remember, you know, books for children, and particularly the books for younger children, they are made up of not just the words, but they are made up of a combination of the words and the pictures. So to just read a book and not pay attention to the illustrations would mean that, you know, you're only getting half the enjoyment out of it. So always make it a point to look at the pictures. You know, look at this. There's so much you can do here. So many things you can talk about. Why are his slippers here? What do you notice here? Where is the chameleon? Alright, so these are the four things that you can do as you read a book with your child. And don't worry, these little activities are not going to turn it into some kind of a very difficult situation for your child. If you do it well, if you do it in a fun and interesting way, your child is actually going to look forward to these questions that you ask, these little pointers that you give, because they are going to enhance his enjoyment of the book. So do try out these little tips that I have offered here and let me know how your child reacted to this. If you have any other questions or doubts, do leave them in the comment section and I'll get back to you. So until the next time, keep reading, keep smiling. Bye-bye and thanks for watching.